This is new in America. It didn't used to be this way. Before 1976, student loans were treated like other types of unsecured debt in bankruptcy. If you were facing financial ruin, you could get relief. But then Congress got the idea that student borrowers were running to bankruptcy court right after graduation. This notion was based on more anecdote than data. But Congress started passing laws to make it harder to discharge student loans. From 1978 to 1998, Congress made it so there were only two ways to get a student loan discharge: prove you had undue hardship, or wait a period of years after the loan became due before filing bankruptcy. First, it was a five-year waiting period. Then it became 7 years. Then in 1998, Congress rewrote the Higher Education Act, excuse me, and as a budget offset, tucked in a provision getting rid of the waiting period for student loan dischargeability. Under the law now, there is no length of time, no waiting period. Now federal student loans can only be discharged if the borrower proves he or she had undue hardship. Well, that's an interesting standard. How is it applied? Proving undue hardship is nearly impossible. Starting with a 1987 case called Brunner, courts have interpreted the phrase to set an impossibly high bar for relief. To pass the Brunner test of undue hardship, you have to convince a bankruptcy judge that it's hopeless that you'll ever repay, while the Department of Education or its guarantee agents are on the other side arguing against you. In 2017, the Wall Street Journal looked around for undue hardship cases. They found four cases in the nation when a bankruptcy judge discharged student debt for undue hardship. Four. I've tried for years to push the Department of Education to stop aggressively challenging undue hardship claims by student borrowers. I'm still pushing. I use the example of a quadriplegic disabled veteran. It didn't move them a bit, but Congress can. We made a mistake in 1998. Undue hardship should not be the only path to address student loans in bankruptcy. There should be another option. We should go back to how it was before 1998, when borrowers could seek relief after a significant waiting period. That system worked. That's why today I'm introducing a bill with Senator Cornyn, and I thank him for joining me in this bipartisan effort. It's called Fresh Start Through Bankruptcy Act. We have talked about this problem of student loan and student debt long enough. It's time to fix it. Our bill would restore the ability of student loan borrowers to discharge federal student loans after a waiting period of 10 years. And it would pair this reform with accountability measures for colleges and schools that have consistently high default rates. We are sending a message to these schools. You are loaning taxpayers' money to students who count on your advice. The system is broken down. Universities have to be part of the solution. Everyone has skin in the game. You are no different. This is a big moment. I've been introducing student loan bankruptcy for a long time. This is the first time it's been bipartisan. Thank you, Senator. With this bill, we see a growing bipartisan consensus that the status quo isn't working and we need student loan bankruptcy reform. I want to thank Senator Cornyn again for joining me, and I want to thank our panel of witnesses for being here today.